Welcome back, guys. Chris here, and I'm bringing you the February 2025 edition of NetSuite News. A lot of different things to talk about. Most importantly, there's the upcoming first release of 2025 for NetSuite. So we're going to talk about some of the new features and updates related to that release. But before we dive into that, I do want to say, just in relation to SuperTraining itself, we just hit the 10,000 subscriber mark on YouTube, which is a huge deal. I remember just last year, around the January point, we had just hit 1,000 subscribers. So we've come a long way in the past year, and I really hope to have 2025 be an amazing year. We've got a lot of different things happening. As I mentioned a couple months ago, I'm starting to roadmap some SAP content that I'm going to be putting out, and I might even do a few courses on Sage as well. So we're starting to expand out from just NetSuite, which is not the only thing I know how to talk about, into some of the other ERPs. So hopefully that's going to be coming soon. But don't worry, I will continue to make NetSuite content as I always have. I'm going to keep rolling out YouTube videos, and I have an entire lineup of courses that are going to be rolling out over the next few months, starting with this next module, which is a course I'm working on right now for the MRP module in NetSuite. So if you're not already familiar with it, MRP stands for Material Requirements Planning. And it's basically a more sophisticated replenishment system for inventory. Specifically, it brings in the added functionality of demand planning. So MRP, when you talk about NetSuite and inventory management in general, it's not necessarily what NetSuite's known for, but I feel that the MRP module is definitely, once you get over the learning curve with it, it definitely is a stable and functioning module. It's something that I've seen a lot of clients have success with. And my recommendations in general is that when you want to go onto something like MRP, especially if you're doing a new implementation, I generally recommend that clients just try to get onto NetSuite and go live first without bringing in MRP. You can either rely on your earlier replenishment system or maybe go with something simple like reorder points at first, get stable on NetSuite for a number of months, maybe half a year, and at that point, now try to make the additional transition into including the MRP module. So that is my recommendation. And in terms of the module itself, I have this course I'm coming out with is going to be relatively short as a course, maybe 10 videos in total, and breaking apart all the fundamental steps, including configuration and the basic planning workbench, using some key reports that allow the system really to work at its optimum state. And with this course, really breaking down the complexity of MRP into more digestible, understandable pieces, I really do feel like even for someone who is not familiar with MRP and really not familiar with inventory management in general, it should be a course that you can get through, understand the basics, and then go into a more complicated setup with a real client, whether that's yours or a client you're dealing with, and implement an MRP setup that is successful and debug any issues that you run into. So keep an eye out for that. It's coming out in the next probably 1 or 2 weeks, and you can take advantage of it. I'll have another YouTube video coming out specifically when it is released. So that is on the near horizon. And now let's talk about the upcoming NetSuite release. So if you're not already familiar with it, NetSuite as a product has two releases that occur every single year, and they're not voluntary. NetSuite basically forces you to go through with it. They're gonna update the system for everybody, and they do it twice a year, one early on in the year and one a little bit later. So this release is gonna be implementing sometime between mid-March and April. They roll it out kind of in phases amongst clients. So you'll find out exactly when your crossover is to the new release. But in general, there's hundreds of changes. There's sometimes new features that come in. Sometimes they're making changes, debugging problems that have come up, and they just do it all at once. They'll notify you when it's coming up. And you can take advantage, if you're already live on NetSuite, you can take advantage of the release preview accounts. You have to sign up for them. You get access. It's basically a demo environment in the new system that allows you to have your files and records, meaning you have your main production account, but the release preview has kind of like a copy of it that allows you to test how things are working, especially for integrations or more advanced customizations, to make sure that the release preview and what the release is gonna have coming out isn't gonna break something that you have already working in your system. So if you're worried about something like that, definitely take advantage of the release preview. But to talk more specifically about what's coming out in the release, As I mentioned, there's hundreds of small changes, but generally there's some major things that NetSuite promotes as their big new features coming out or really significant changes to existing features. And as you've probably gotten the vibe or feeling of, obviously in the last couple of years, NetSuite's really been focusing on AI type products and things like that. So a lot of the things that they're hyping are in relation to that. But I think most importantly to talk about in relation to this upcoming release is actually the change with the UI. So I've mentioned some of my earlier videos that there is this new Redwood user interface. It's got a bit of a cleaner, more modern look in any of my recent videos or demos and full-fledged courses. You've definitely seen the Redwood UI in those. And in general, nothing's changing, right? It's just cosmetic changes as of now. But up until now, you had the ability to choose whether you want to have on Redwood or not. And what they're doing with this new release is they're having anyone new that's coming along is going to be defaulted into Redwood. So they're trying to have people that are being newly introduced to the system just get familiar with Redwood and leave it at that. And you have to keep in mind, if you are using currently the old kind of classic look of the user interface, at some point, whether 6 months from now, maybe 3 years from now, they will be forcing everyone to switch onto Redwood. So I do recommend if you have some time, you know, just check it out, get a feel for the Redwood UI. I know not everyone loves it, but try it out. If it's not something you absolutely hate and you're able to work in it, again, considering the fact that nothing's actually changing, all the buttons are still in the same place, I do recommend you make that transition before you're forced to at a certain point down the line. And the next thing I want to talk about is the NetSuite Expert. So this is an AI tool that is going to be incorporated in with Suite Answers. So when you're searching for something, similar to like if you go on Google and you ask it a question like how far is the moon from Earth, instead of just giving you a bunch of website links, it has the AI try to give you an answer to that right at the top. It's going to do a similar thing where instead of just giving you a bunch of articles on Suite Answers, the NetSuite Expert's going to try to take the information from these various articles and boil it into hopefully as relevant an answer as possible to whatever you're asking and put that up front. And then you can look at the articles down below if you want. That is going to be coming out. Now, up until now, and I have mentioned this in earlier videos, I personally use ChatGPT as an AI tool. Some people use DeepSeek or the Copilot. Any of these things can be utilized. And I do recommend you at least try these things out because I'm finding that as these AI tools are getting better and better, they're becoming increasingly more helpful to solve particular problems. Or what I use it for a lot is if I have, let's say, formulas that I'm trying to do in safe searches, I don't know exactly how to write the formula, I can just go into ChatGPT, it'll give me a detailed instruction on that. I simply copy that over into NetSuite and roll with it. It's certainly not right 100% of the time. I'd say it's probably closer to 50, between 50 and 70%, but it's very easy to check it, see if it's getting the answer right or it's pointing you in the right direction. And if it is, great, use it. If it's not, then fine, try to rely on something else like Suite Answers. So we'll see when that AI tool comes out in Suite Answers, if it holds up and is comparable to some of these other AI tools. I hope it is, but it remains to be seen. Hopefully, as we interact with it, these things also get more sophisticated and improve as the time goes on. So that is the NetSuite Expert AI tool. Another AI tool I want to comment on is NetSuite Narrative Reporting. This is one that they're heavily promoting because it is an AI tool that allows you to, in plain English, basically tell the system what you want and it starts generating these reports and pulling information in as necessary. So you can say, I want a pie chart that's going to show me this information and I need another report pulling in this information from these different locations, compile it in this way. And it can be a very useful tool. It's actually one that I saw demoed at SuiteWorld 2024. It was very impressive. The one little caveat that is kind of left out of the marketing pitch is that this is not actually for NetSuite. This is for an Oracle product called Enterprise Performance Management. It is a separate product. They've rebranded a lot of Oracle products as NetSuite products because they can plug into NetSuite, but they are different. It's not like you're logging into NetSuite. You're logging into a separate Oracle product that has this capability called narrative reporting. So it's a little misleading in the marketing pitch. If you have this other Oracle product or some of the other ones they've got, they are implementing a lot of AI tools into these products. And from what I've seen in demos, they're actually quite sophisticated. But you have to keep in mind, it is not NetSuite. If you're just paid for NetSuite, you're not gonna be having access to any of these things. They are separate paid for products. So keep that in mind. But to continue on with AI products that are related to NetSuite, I've commented in earlier videos about the text enhance feature, which I think overall is a cool feature. I find that there's only a few use cases where I think it's gonna be really helpful or make things more efficient for a company. But the concept in general is that there's a number of fields in NetSuite, like a sales description, where you might wanna put information. Instead of having to type it out for every single item, you can use Text Enhance to basically give it some information on what you need, and then it will generate using AI whatever the appropriate sales description. You can give it some parameters to try to pull it back or have it expand out further. And what they're coming out with is a prompting studio, which is kind of a fancy name for it. Really, it's just a preferences page that allows you to add additional conditions or parameters to guide the text enhance as it goes through these various fields. So you can get it closer and closer to the style of writing and the type of information that you want to have in whatever fields you're going to be including with text enhance, so that it really gets tailored to you. And again, it hopefully will save your company time. And the last AI tool I want to comment on is bill capture. This is something I've spoken a lot about in previous videos. It is my favorite AI feature they've come out with so far. It basically just scans bills that you're receiving as a company, and it uses what's called OCR, which is just really character recognition, to pull in relevant fields and populate a bill in NetSuite, which is incredibly helpful, and it can save a lot of time for, I would say, most companies. If you're willing to get used to how the system works, it is pretty much uniform helpful for any different type of client. So this is something that has existed for about 6 months or a year at this point, and they're getting better and better at the character recognition and its ability to add additional settings or really carefully look through and see things that are maybe obscured or have different names than what you would have on your form for a bill. And they're adding an additional feature with this new release that not only makes the character recognition better, but it can also, when scanning a new bill, it can also pull information that's relevant from a connected or what should be a connected purchase order, to just make sure that as much information is being fed into this as possible, so you don't need that manual entry from one of your accounts payable clerks. So that's it for the AI features, but there's a lot of other things that are rolling out. Two in particular I want to comment on. One is, there was in the last release, there was a version of NetSuite that came out to allow for HIPAA compliances. So this is for regulations in the healthcare or health services industry, where you really have to have patient information be quite secure and you have to actually follow federal laws on the subject. They came out with that in the last release. Now they're coming out with Compliance 360, which is a feature that just further improves and facilitates companies that want to do business, are operating on NetSuite, but they do need to be in compliance with HIPAA. It just makes that a smoother process, so they're able to have all things properly where they should be and the regulations met as they need to be. And then lastly, there is the Customer 360 dashboard. This has been a very useful tool that's existed for quite some time now, especially for sales representatives. If they're calling people up and they are operating within the system, they want to be able to just pull up a customer and see all kinds of information about that customer. That has existed for a while. NetSuite's been making it kind of systematically better and better with the different releases. And they're now adding a bunch of additional charts, graphs, and tools that will allow your sales representatives to get a really comprehensive view of the customer that they're trying to reach out to. So that's it in terms of the, I think, major topics and releases on the upcoming release. I will include a link down below for the entire listing of release notes, and you can go through that and see if there's anything relevant to you. And before we wrap up this video, there's one additional thing I wanted to comment on, which is in terms of upcoming events, they did come out with the dates for the upcoming SuiteWorld in 2025. So last year, it was held in August, early August, and it's now going to be held in October 6th to the 9th. And I think that's great for two particular reasons. One, if you've ever been to Las Vegas in August, it's incredibly hot. The highs average over 100 degrees every day. Last year, it was definitely hot. You're usually in business casual when you're at SuiteWorld, so it can be particularly uncomfortable. Having it in October is a much, much more temperate month. It's still warm, but it's no longer uncomfortably hot. It's probably one of the best times to go to Las Vegas in. So definitely happy that the times that you are going to be outside, it's not going to be nearly as uncomfortable. And then secondly, instead of having it at the exact same time as Oracle Cloud World, as they did in 2024, where there's just a lot of things happening at the same time, and the Oracle PR and marketing teams trying to juggle both of these massive events, they're doing it this year where it's going to be SuiteWorld first, and then a week later, they're going to have Cloud World. So thankfully, those are split up. That gives a little bit more attention to each event separately, and I think it should be a great event coming up this year. So I probably won't comment on that so much in the upcoming NetSuite news videos until we get closer to maybe August or September, and I'll start releasing guides for SuiteWorld and what to look forward to. So hopefully this video was helpful and informational for you. If so, please hit that like button, subscribe if you want to see more content like this, and I'll see you next month.